Welcome back, myself, Mrs. Felina Gonsalves, teacher of Chitvidya Mandir, English High School, Maharashtra Board, Vasai. Today we are going to learn Chapter 13 of Science for Standard 6th. The topic is sound. What is sound? Sound is created when something vibrates and sends waves of energy into our ears. The vibration travels through the air or another medium, that is, solid, liquid or gas. The stronger the vibration, the louder the sound. For example, when a school bell rings, part of the bell will vibrate, creating sound. Sound can be of different types, such as soft, loud, present, unpresent. Some sounds are loud and are clear, heard easily, while some other are very soft and cannot be heard unless we listen attentively. We like some sound. On the other hand, we get annoyed by some other sounds. How sounds are produced? Try this. When a song is being played on a radio or a music system in the house, place your hand on its speaker. What do you feel? Now put out the music. Now what will you feel? Take a rubber band and stretch it as shown in the picture. Plug the stretch band. Apart from the movement of the rubber band, what else did you notice? Spread some sawdust or mustard seed on sand on diaphragm of a tabla. Knock on diaphragm lightly with a finger. What do you see happening? So long as the tabla makes a sound, what happens when the sound stops? The object that produces sound, that is the diaphragm of the speaker, the rubber band and diaphragm of a tabla, show a certain movement, that is, they have a certain kind of motion. They oscillate rapidly. In other words, it vibrates. So we can say that the vibration of an object is very important for production of sound. As long as the object vibrates, the sound is heard. When the vibration stops, the sound also stops. The object due to which sound is produced is called the source of the sound. Acoustic. The science of sound resonance, including the production, propagation and effect of sound, is called acoustic. The intensity of sound is measured in a unit called decibel, that is dB. The vibration of the vocal cord in our larynx or voice box also produce sound. The voice box is located in our throat. The quality of the sound produced in the larynx depends upon the thoroughness of the vocal cord. How sound is heard? There is air around the source of sound. As the source of sound begins to vibrate, the layer of air nearest to the source also vibrates. A wave of vibration of that sound spreads in all directions from the source of sound. Such a wave is called a sound wave. The sound waves reach our ears. There is a delicate diaphragm or eardrum in the cavity of our ears. It starts vibrating too. The sensation produced by these vibrations are passed on to the brain, to the nerves in the ear, and we hear the sound. What is propagation of sound? Sound is said to be propagated when sound waves spread in all directions from a source of sound. Now, take two balloons, fill air in one and water in the other. Press the balloon filled with air against your ears as shown in the picture. Now, rub a finger on the balloon and listen to the sound. Repeat the same activity with the balloon filled with water. Through which balloon do we hear a clear sound? Sound travels in the form of waves through air, water or through a solid and reaches our ear. Sound is propagated more clearly through a liquid than through air. It is heard more clearly through a solid. Now stand at the end of a big table and make a friend stand at the other end. Ask the friend to knock lightly on a table. What will you hear? Medium of propagation of sound. The substance around the source of sound through which sound waves spread is called the medium of propagation of sound. Transmission of sound occurs at a different speed to different medium. Transmission of sound is faster through a liquid than through a gas and faster through a solid than through a liquid. Noise pollution. Noise pollution occurs when we hear one or many sounds that are harmful to our ears. The harsh and unwanted sound that produces discomfort is called noise. Noise pollution occurs when there is one or more noises around us that are harmful. This kind of continuous noise can cause ill effect on health. Now let's know the effect of noise pollution. The hearing capacity of the ears is lessened and it may cause deafness. There is mental exhaustion due to constant noise. There is restlessness and mental irritability. One cannot work with concentration. Measure preventing noise pollution. We should not blow horns of the vehicle unnecessarily. The volume of TV or radio should be kept at minimum restricted to those who are watching or listening to the program. Maintenance of vehicle should be done so that they will not produce noise. Factories, airport, railway station and bus stand should not be located in the restricted area, but they should be away from locality where people stay. Copy down the following assignment. Thank you for watching the video.